Hello interwebs, how are you doing? I am doing well. So the last couple of videos I put up have been a couple days late, so I'm going to try to put this one up within like 48 hours of filming it. That would be a new world record for me. Anyways, I'm moving on Friday. Today is Monday, and we're closing on Thursday, and then I'm moving on Friday. So this is crazy, because I'm moving across the state. Like, I've moved before. Like, when I first started doing my YouTube channel, we actually were, like, in this temporary living situation with my mother-in-law. And then we moved into our old apartment, which was horrible. Do you guys remember? I had, like, sailboats on my wall. Really bad. Then we bought this house, and we moved in here. But all of those places were within 10 minutes of each other. Like, it was all within a very close radius. And, we're actually moving across the state, like all the way across the state, almost to Canada. We're moving like 2.5 hours away from where I live right now, which is very stressful because we're only moving 10 minutes away. You can take 2, 3, 4, 5 trips, it's not a big deal, you can go back in the morning, like, but we really need to minimize the amount of trips we're taking because it's 5 hours driving, you know, round trip. So I'm super excited because I love my new house. I literally am obsessed with it. It's funny because it's a little smaller than this house that we're in now, but I think we're in a house that's too big for us right now. Right now there's the two of us and then we have two dogs. You guys know Stanley lives with Erica now. So we have two dogs and 5 cats, which seems like a lot, but like honestly we have way more room than we need. Like the guest bedroom door is almost always shut. It's been used a handful of times since we lived here. I will still have a guest bedroom in our new house, but that's not the point. So that's a room that's really not used. We also have an abundance of closets in this house, which is very odd because this house was built, and I believe it's like up, it's because the house is so old and like building codes didn't used to be like a big deal. I'm actually not sure when this house was built because the realtor told me 1908 when we bought the house, but then I called the county assessors like trying to find out what the original house looked like because it's been renovated so many times, and they told me 1912. So I'm not really sure, but it's sometime around 1910. So this house is easily over 100 years old, and it's very odd to have a lot of closets in a house like that because that's not how the world worked back in the day. But we have a ton of closets. Like, there is a closet in every single bedroom. Then upstairs, there's also a huge walk-in closet, big enough where if it had a heat, like it doesn't have a heat vent in it, which is why it couldn't be a bedroom of its own, but if it had a heat vent, you could put a twin bed and a dresser in there and it would be big enough for a bedroom. I mean, it's huge. So we have that walk-in closet. We also have a closet in the hallway out here. I guess the apartment does not have a closet, but it's got a closet, a big like walk-in closet in the living room, so it's not a big deal. Anyways, what I'm saying is there's a lot of closets in this house. There's a lot of like space in this house that goes really to waste. We have a lot of like odd rooms. Like we're using the master bedroom technically as the living room, and then the living room is being used as this weird like cat room. I swear, it's the room where we like feed the cats, we feed the dogs, we have all of our animal stuff, which is really unnecessary. It's just because we have a room and we didn't want it to be empty. Then we have two dining rooms. We have like an eat-in kitchen dining room, and then we have a formal dining room. And the formal dining room is being used as Nick's office, and then we're using the other room as a dining room, but we really don't even use the kitchen table. It's just a catch-all for like boxes and packages and mail and things that should be put away that we're procrastinating. So I'm excited because even though we're losing some square footage, I think we're gaining a lot more usable space. And plus the yard is so nice. Ah, I'm so excited for the yard. Oh my gosh, did you know what happened in my current yard? So I'm still in my current house, obviously. But so my back fence neighbors had this giant, like, mountainous ice boulder on their roof. And if you live in New York, you know that you're supposed to, like, break icicles as they form, unless you live in a giant two-story house. But as icicles are getting closer to the ground, you should be breaking them so that they're not like building up and becoming gigantic. Well, they did no sort of maintenance involving the snow and ice on their roof, and this giant like 250-pound ice boulder fell off their house and crashed through our fence, and then they haven't even moved it. It's been there for like 10 days and like they haven't even acknowledged it. So we have to go over there and be like, hey, bros, you broke our fence, and please call your homeowner's insurance, because we were going to just, like, kind of, like, rig it together and fix it, because that is possible, but the truth is, like, their homeowner's insurance will pay for that, and, like, why should we have, like, we're going to resell this house in a couple of years, and, like, I think that would detract from the value of the house if people see that the fence is, like, all boarded up and weird. So I really would like them to fix it properly, especially since it was not our fault. It was an act of nature, and they should have insurance that covers something like that, and if they don't, we'll go from there, because I don't want to, like, I don't want to hurt anybody financially. I'm not that much of a jerk. But I would like to at least see if it's an option to like, have their homeowner's insurance cover fixing the fence. These are adult problems. My neighbors broke my fence. So that's a thing, and what else? So I'm obsessed with Disney Tsum Tsum. You guys know I've been playing the game. I don't know if you can see her, but Avery's got Marie on her lap. And then my little sister got me Dumbo. Look how cute he is. And then I bought Eeyore. And look at his little tail. Ah, so cute. And they have, like, beans in them so that, like, just in the bottom so that they stay nice and they stack well. And then I also got Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers. Super excited. I also ordered Rolly in the mail, and hopefully he'll come, like, tomorrow before I move. I'm hoping he gets here before I move. And then I have to change all of my mail. We ordered new desks because, as you guys have seen in my videos, my desk is wrecked. Hashtag wrecked. It was like a Walmart, so it was like Mainstays, and it was like $80 when I bought it, and it had like a big hutch on it. But the hutch was actually very inconvenient because I had dual monitors, and like one of my monitors didn't quite fit under it properly, and I would always like hit myself on it. Like, I don't really know how that's possible, but I did. I like hurt myself on it all the time. So I finally took the hutch off, and so I've been using it as just like an L-shaped surface, which is fine, except you can't see it because I'm not gonna like tip my desk down. My desk is covered in crap. Like, I have all these cute little, like, look at my little pen organizer, and this is a swivelly, well, I can't really do it, but you get it. It's like a swivelly, see? That's my little pen organizer. I also have, like, another organizer over there. I have this one here. Like, I have so many things to try to organize my desk, and it's still just, like, covered in stuff. So I really need, like, storage of some sort, like, drawers. Drawers would be so great. So Nick and I both ordered new desks. We got the same desk in different colors. His is, like, mahogany or something like that, and mine's, like, sandy oak. Or oak sand. I don't know. I don't know what it's called. Salt oak? Oak salt? Something like that. But mine looks kind of like a distressed wood, and his looks very, like, rich and manly. And we're actually having them delivered to the new house. So I'm super excited about the new desk, because this desk is like a piece of garbage, if I'm being totally honest. And I'm a little overwhelmed. We have a lot to do. Like, I think I'm going to bring this. I don't know if you can see it, but it's, like, really rickety. Oh, my gosh, I'm going to knock all my stuff over. But I don't know what I'm going to do. I haven't decided, because a lot of these shelving units I got from Walmart for very cheap, which is wonderful to have things that are very cheap because they're very cheap. But then in the same sense, they're very cheap, and they don't survive moves very well. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do, because I think where I'm filming in my new house, there's actually a window behind me. So I need to get, like, a blackout shade, and then I'm going to put, like, stuff in front of it. It's, like, kind of crappy that I'm going to be blocking out that source of natural light, but it's also, I'm going to sneeze. I'm going to sneeze. Bless me. So it's, like, kind of annoying that I'm blocking out a source of natural light, but in the same sense, I can't have light behind me. It'll mess up the lighting of my video, I think. I'm not sure. Yeah, I think it will. So I'm probably going to, like, put a blackout curtain there and then put two big shelves behind me that go, like, all the way up. I don't know. I clearly haven't figured out what I'm going to do yet, but I need room to display my things. And I don't think Chen is going to be in my new background. I'm bringing him with me, but I think I would rather have more shelves with stuff, because you guys don't understand, I have an entire, like, box of stuff that isn't, I don't have any place to display it. So I, like, really want, like, right now I've got this back wall decorated, but nothing else is decorated. Well, I guess I have my wall of posters over there, but I don't even think that counts. I mean, I really want my new office to just be, like, Danielle threw up all of the things she likes. So I'm super excited to decorate, even though I'll have no time to do so. I'm freaking out. Freaking out. I'm going to be doing the Wowhead podcast from now on, the Wowhead Weekly, which I'm so, so excited about, because I don't think you guys get it. Like, when I started doing these videos, it was just, well, not these videos, not this video in particular, but, like, Trade Chat. When I started making World of Warcraft videos on Trade Chat, I never thought that that would accomplish anything. And now I'm working with, in my opinion, one of the most well-known and well-respected and, like, prestigious fan sites, and I'm like, can't screw it up. I'm freaking out. So I'm not starting this week because I'm obviously moving on Friday, so I can't do that. But I'm actually going to start next week, and I'm, like, really nervous, because when Olivia did the podcast, she actually did all the, like, she streamed it, she did, like, the changing of cameras, she did everything. Like, she did all the things. And so now I have to do all the things, and I don't want to screw it up. I want to do a good job. I really, really, really want to do a good job. Like, Ah, so, and that starts like a week after I move in. Like, I'll barely be settled. So I need to get at least what's going on behind me settled. And I also, I have like a, I need to get my mic situation figured out because right now I'm just talking to my camera mic. Like, that's how I'm doing this. But when I do my trade chat videos, I usually use my studio condenser mic because it sounds a little bit better. I don't know why, it just does, but it, I also have the problem where this is a big empty room, so you can kind of hear that I'm in a big empty room, and so I think what I'm going to do is use a desk mic that's like on my desk, like a different mount that's like in front of me so that I'm not so far away from the mic, and I think that will help with that problem, and then I'll still use this one for like Let's Plays. It's a... Oh, I've been packing so much. Like, you never know how much stuff you have until you start packing it. I mean, it doesn't look like I've been packing because you're seeing this wall, but, like, my closet, I filled up 3 extra large U-Haul boxes of clothes. That's not okay. That's too many clothes. And I packed, like, all my craft stuff. I filled, like, 4 or 5 boxes, like, medium boxes of craft stuff. I just, like, I have so much stuff. I think I have a whole medium box just of fabric. That's not okay. Or it is okay. I'm not sure. I just, like, ugh. Moving is a big deal. Oh, excuse me. So anyways, we're closing on Thursday, and when we go out on Thursday, we're gonna try to like bring out a lot of boxes and stuff, because why waste the trip, you know? Like, at least try to make it worth it. So we're gonna try to bring out like a lot of boxes when we go on Thursday to try to like maximize how much we can get done on Friday. And then we have to have an electrician. He's going to be here. I need to film my video because the electrician is going to be here, like, soon. Because there's, like, we're trying to get this house ready for, like, our tenants who are renting it. Ah! Just so much to do. So I just want to fill you in. If I don't make a vlog for a little while, it's not intentional. It's just that I'm obscenely busy. But once I get in my new house, I think I'll actually be vlogging a lot. And I feel like I told you that when I moved in here. Like, oh, once I move, I'm going to be vlogging so much. But no, Tyke, you shh. But once I move, Nick will be working away from... Tychus, no, stop it. You stop. He doesn't like it when I talk to the camera because he doesn't understand who I'm talking to. And he, like, thinks I'm talking to him, but I'm not facing the right way, and he just doesn't like it. Anyways, when we move, Nick is going to be working in an office every day. Like, right now he works from home, which is part of the reason I don't vlog, because I'm just, like, hanging out and, like, whatever. And I don't know. I'm, like, really weird. I don't want to interrupt my life to vlog. Like, I feel like that's very inorganic, if that makes any sense. It was always easier for me to vlog, like, when I worked at the game store and I was, like, by myself. Like, I don't want to, like, hush somebody or make somebody be my vlog that doesn't want to be. So, anyways... I digress. I'll be spending a lot more time by myself, and I'm also going to be doing like agility training with Tychus, so I would love to like bring my camera and stuff like that if you guys would be interested in watching those videos. I also, since my office and my craft room will be one in the same, I would also like to be making more crafting type videos because that's something I really enjoy doing, and I think that would be a fun thing to do. I'm gonna go. Tychus is being very annoying and demanding right now. So I'm gonna go see if I can get him to shh. I'm gonna film my Wowhead video, and I'm gonna hope I get all this done before the electrician comes. So I will talk to you soon. I hope you have a wonderful day. I love you all. You're in my hearts. I'll see you soon. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.